Hello everyone, hope you all are doing well. In this video I'll talk about the BitLocker. BitLocker overview, BitLocker deployment scenario, TBM definition and how it's work, difference between UEFI and legacy BIOS, difference between MBR and GPT, how to convert the disk from MBR to GPT without data loss or reinstalling Windows. Let's start. As we all know, the BitLocker is a Microsoft full disk encryption feature that designed to protect the operating system and entire volumes from the offline attacks and unauthorized access by providing a full volume encryption on your Windows system. As you see, the BitLocker can be deployed in many different ways based on your situation. TBM only uses the computer's TBM security hardware and doesn't require any interaction with the user to unlock and provide access to the drive. This means that the user can start the computer without being prompted for a PIN or anything else. Dongle only. This scenario is requiring using of the Active Directory group policy to allow the BitLocker without a TPM and use a startup key on a USB flash drive instead of TBM. However, the loss of the USB can put the protected system at risk. TBM plus PIN. In addition to the protection that the TBM provides, BitLocker requires a user enter a PIN, because the data on the encrypted volume cannot be accessed without entering the PIN. TBM plus dongle, or TBM with a startup key. In addition to the protection that the TBM only provides, part of the encryption key stored on a USB flash drive, referred to as a startup key, and the data on the encrypted volume cannot be accessed without the startup key. Also, the TBM only can be used for zero-touch BitLocker deployment for a corporate. And you can deploy and configure the BitLocker to encrypt the drive by using TBM only and automatically save the recovery key and password in Active Directory. And in this scenario, and in addition to a compatible version of Windows, Trusted Platform Module TBM version 1.2 or higher is required. TBM is a dedicated microcontroller or dedicated processor inside the motherboard on most new PCs that enables the device to support advanced security features and to secure the hardware through integrated cryptographic keys. And when the BitLocker turned on, will encrypt the hard disk and store the key inside the TBM and then publish the recovery key and password to Active Directory if you configure the Active Directory group policy to save the recovery key and password to Active Directory. Likewise, next time when you put into your system, the TBM will perform system integrity checks at a high level on a critical early boot components like boot configuration data, BIOS, fingerprint, hard disk. Then the TBM collects and stores the measurements from multiple early boot component and boot configuration data to create a system identifier for that computer and store each part of this as a hash in a platform configuration registry. If the TBM verifies system integrity and no change and everything is normal, the TBM will supply a unique code called a cryptographic key, and the BitLocker will decrypt the protected volume, then the operating system starts normally. If the early boot components are changed or tampered with, such as changing the BIOS settings, changing the master boot record, or moving the hard disk to a different computer, the TBM prevents BitLocker from unlocking the encrypted volume, and the computer enters recovery mode and cannot start until adding the BitLocker recovery key. Okay, to summarize what has been said, to enable the BitLocker, the following requirements must be met. The computer must have a TBM version 1.2 or higher and must be enabled. To check the TBM version, open run and type tbm.msc to open the TBM management console. As you see, the status and the version of TBM. Also, you can check the version of TBM from the computer device manager under the security device. As you see, TBM version 1.2. A computer with a TBM must also require a unified extensible firmware interface, UEFI, for this device. At this point, you have to know the difference between UEFI and legacy BIOS, as it's a very important section and will help you to know if the computer ready for the BitLocker or not. Okay, both UEFI and legacy BIOS are low-level software stored on the motherboard. When the power button is pressed, BIOS or UEFI is the first software that runs before booting the operating systems. Both of these firmware interfaces are used at the startup of the computer to initialize the hardware component, ensuring they are functioning properly, and then running the bootloader that boots the operating system. Okay, already UEFI replaced the legacy BIOS on all Neoli PCs, but the major difference between UEFI and legacy BIOS? In UEFI, faster boot time. UEFI has a fast and ultra-fast option that allows your computer to boot much faster than normal, as it's allowed the motherboard to initialize the hardware components at once. More secure, as it provides secure booting to prevent digitally unassigned drivers from loading. Also, it has a better power management. UEFI based on GPT partition style that preventing the PC from being damaged by malware. Better compatibility with a big hard disk drive as it's based on GPT partition style and support large than 2 terabyte and more 128 primary partitions. Maximum partition capacity 1 billion terabytes. Better graphic support in the interface. Also, ability to use the mouse and has a detailed settings menu, more useful. In legacy BIOS, old boot with a slow startup time and has not improved since the day of Microsoft DOS, and it's already more than 30 years old. No secure boot, as it doesn't offer any boot security. Also, any bootloader can be run. Based on MBR, old partition style that have some limitations for modern usage and hard disk. Support only 4 primary partitions and older versions of Windows. Maximum partition capacity 2 terabytes. Okay, to check if the computer using legacy BIOS or UEFI, from start menu, open system information and check the BIOS mode section, UEFI or legacy. Okay, now let's go back to the BitLocker requirements. We talked about the required version of TBM, also the difference between UEFI and legacy BIOS. Let's go through the rest of requirements. A USB drive or other external media should be available to store the recovery key. If you will use TBM with the USB scenario or USB only. 2 partitions are required to run the BitLocker. Because pre-startup authentication and system integrity verification must occur on a separate partition from the encrypted operating system drive. The computer must be connected to the domain in order to store the recovery key in Active Directory. Okay. To check if a disk uses GPT or MBR partition style, from start menu, open disk management console, right-click on your disk, select Properties, go to Volume tab, check the partition style, if it's MBR or GPT. Okay, now let's see how to install new operating system based on UEFI and GPT partition style to be able to turn on the BitLocker without any problem. There are two cases to install a new operating system. If it's a new computer with new hard disk, no data, so we will do a clean install of Windows. If the computer already in use and the disk with data and not configured as a GPT. In both cases, you should create UEFI portable USB Windows installation that supports UEFI mode. Rufus is a pest-free application. You can download it from the link and make UEFI portable USB Windows installation. Connect the USB drive to any computer. Open Rufus application. The application will detect automatically the USB. Select the Windows ISO image. From partition schema section, select GPT. From file system section, select NTFS. Press start to create the UEFI portable USB Windows installation. Once done and completed successfully, restart the computer and put into the BIOS settings. Go to Put Options menu. Select UEFI only. From security section, select secure boot and disable it. And when the Windows installation complete, you should enable it again. Save and restart. This was the first steps in both cases we have mentioned. Let's proceed in the new computer setup. Connect the USB drive to boot from the Windows 10 installation USB flash drive. Change your computer's boot order to be able to boot from USB flash drive. Press any key to boot from USB. Follow the normal steps and once reach the type of installation window, click on Custom. As you see, the new hard disk show up as an allocated space. No matter how many partition you want to create, you should keep the first one unallocated and press Next. Windows installation will automatically create the required operating system partitions with GPT partition style. Select the primary partition and press Next and follow the normal steps. And when the Windows installation done, you can enable the BitLocker normally without any problem. Okay, this was the first case. The second case, if the computer already in use, and the disk with data and not configured as a GPT partition style. This case includes the PCs with expired operating system and need upgrading to the latest version of Windows. Or the PC with latest version of Windows and the disk configured as MBR, old partition style, and you cannot enable the BitLocker until convert the disk to GPT partition style. In both scenario, you can convert the disk without reinstalling Windows, also without data loss, by using Microsoft MBR to GPT tool. That allowing you to convert a disk from MBR to GPT partition style without reinstalling Windows or data loss. This tool is located in Windows System 32 directory on any computer running Windows 10 version 17.03 or higher. Okay, to use this tool, go to Settings, Update and Security, Recovery. Under the Advanced Startup section, click on Restart Now. When the computer starts, click the Troubleshoot, Advanced Options, click on Command Prompt. When the command prompt open, type MBR to GPT slash validate to validate and ensure the disk meets the requirements. Okay, if the command completes successfully without error, proceed and type MBR to GPT slash convert. to convert the disk from MBR to GPT partition style. Once done and completed successfully, turn off the computer, and once start again, you should put into the BIOS settings, go to Boot option menu, and select UEFI only. The computer will start normally and you can turn on the BitLocker without any problem. Okay, there is a very simple way to convert from MBR to GPT without deleting partition or reinstalling Windows or data loss by using OMI partition assistance software. Download and run the application. Right-click on the system disk and select Convert to GPT Disk. Okay. The task moves to the pending section until click Apply to start. And that's it. And your disk converted. Restart and put into the BIOS and switch from legacy to UEFI mode only. And the computer will start normally without any problem, and you can turn on the BitLocker without any problem. Okay, this was all about BitLocker and all relevant settings and tools that will help you to troubleshoot the important issues that prevent you from enable the BitLocker. Thanks, and I hope you have enjoyed. See you in the next video.